Good morning, welcome back to my channel, good afternoon, or whatever it is when you're watching this video. Today is Super Saturday. Woo woo! So today on the menu we have power snatches, we have muscle ups, and then we have like a big like partner wad that me and Ross are gonna do together. And that's basically what we have to do. It's been like, it's weird. So I haven't really been feeling 100% myself in training. Like I haven't really had my explosive power and stuff. I'm kind of hoping today will be slightly better. I've been working on a few technical things, which hopefully are gonna start paying off. And basically we've been working on like some touch and go stuff as well, obviously since doing CrossFit. So that's one of the main things that we're focusing on right now to kind of make sure that I'm prepped if we ever do a competition. So yeah. I also did do like a little physique update, I guess. So it's been like 6 months since I started doing CrossFit. I mean, you can kind of like see now. I feel like I've definitely regained some like musculature. Like I feel more full, like a bit fuller. Definitely most gains in my upper body because CrossFit is mainly upper body and that's pretty like lean. Like I'm weighing around like 75.3 kilos right now, which is quite light for me. I'm usually around the 80 mark. I kind of lost loads of weight when I was on Roxane, but anyways, breakfast time because I'm starving. So for breakfast today we have a omelette with mushrooms and spinach on a wrap and 3 chicken sausages. Basically that's just to get my protein in. I've also started making some fresh orange juice in the morning, which is really giving me life and I absolutely love it. So I kind of wanted to make this video to kind of talk about like a bit of like a comeback story, I guess. So obviously since Roxane, I lost a lot of strength. And coming back, it's been taking like a really long time to kind of like get back to myself again. And I think I wanted to share my 5 top tips for how I have managed to come back and the important things that you need to try and focus on when trying to regain strength, as well as like, I kind of had to like rechange my body composition where I hadn't been training so hard. I'd lost a lot of weight, but also lost a lot of muscle. So it's kind of about rebuilding that strength, rebuilding the muscle, and just like reconfiguring my body composition. And I just want to say that it's not that I wasn't happy with how I looked. Like I think that my body was going through different stages and I was fine with the way that I was. I personally absolutely love being really muscular and being really strong and looking really like fit and healthy. So that's the kind of like goal that I have. So yeah, so these are my 5 top tips for how I'm achieving those. But first we need to go to training. So hang around for the 5 top tips. They're coming just after training. Thank you.
came in and I was like warming up.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, how cool would it be if I touch and go to 65?
Yeah.
So I was like, don't get too distracted. Just like have 65.
You did 66, right?
Yeah, so I went 15, 8, 61, 64, 66,
yeah.
And then 69
for a power.
Yeah,
and then
71 for a full snatch. That's the most I full snatched since I
ages
came back, and probably the best snatch I've ever done, arguably.
Easily, smashed it. One more. Good. Well done. Well done.
It's really weird, like the past few months I like haven't felt myself in training. This is the first day since
ages.
Ages that I feel like myself again.
The old self.
Yeah.
Woo! That's good. And again. And again. Good. How many was that? Is that six? Woo! I was hoping it was. I lost count, so. Woo! Woo! Thumbnail. Woo! Fun, right? Just trust it. That's it, push over. Good. That's the first one out of the way, good. So that's the best that you've done then?
Yeah.
Like the lowest?
I've always been really, really bad at pistols, mainly because my hip is like really weak on one side. So that's the lowest I've done.
Good.
Probably the lowest. Like you say, like you have to like lean onto that leg and like let this leg sort of like do that for like counterbalance.
Number one is eat loads of fruits and veggies. Like, don't underestimate how much of an importance that has on just like your digestive health and the way that your body is able to absorb all of the nutrients that you're giving it. I think it's super underestimated and it's something that you really need to focus on, as well as give you that glow. You know, you want that like beautiful, fresh, nourished glow. You know, and you'll feel so much better in training if you eat lots of fruits, lots of veggies. I have like at least like 2 or 3 servings of vegetables at every single meal, and then I'll try and have fruit before and after training because it's super good to like fuel you and refuel you after training. So number two is eat your protein. Everybody knows this, everybody knows you need to have enough protein, but it can't be said enough. So since I've been trying to like gain my strength back, gain a bit of weight and put like a bit more muscle on, I've been eating over 200 grams of protein a day. So the next video that I'll be posting will be how I eat over 200 grams of protein a day, just to kind of show you, just because I am very conscious of how much protein that I do have, because I have found that like having a lot of whey or having like high concentrated amount of like red meat or things like that do cause my skin to be quite inflamed. So I'll share exactly how I get those 200 grams of protein, but eat your protein, you know. Number three is stay super consistent. Now I can completely understand how hard it is. Since coming back, it's taken me about, I think now it's coming up to 4 months since I stopped taking Roaccutane, which is a really long time. It's actually like flown by, but it's taken me 4 months just to get back to like 80% training wise and like feeling myself again and feeling good again. So just be consistent, try not to be too hard on yourself, start lower than you think you need to start so that you can build up every week so that you don't overdo it, and have someone who understands what you're going through. Having Ross as my coach whilst trying to rebuild strength has been so important, because I've kind of been able to say to him like, some weeks I'm not feeling good, some weeks I'm feeling much better, and we've been able to build like a very like strategic, organized program, which has really, really helped me with my training and coming back. So number four is stay hydrated. So since starting CrossFit, I'm just gonna be honest, I sweat a lot. Like I'm a very like sweaty person. When I go to the gym, I'm like dripping in sweat. From the minute I start to the minute I finish, it's like dripping all the way down me. And I usually get this bit like here in my sports bra, which where like everything like pulls together and looks awful. But basically, because I sweat so much, it's so, so important to rehydrate. So when I'm training, I do have an isotonic drink, which has like sugars and salts and vitamins and minerals that help you rehydrate. And that's been super, super important in like my ability to like maintain energy levels and things during training. As well as after training, I try and drink a liter and a half of water within like 2.5-3 hours, just to make sure that I'm replenishing all of the water that I've just lost whilst training, and making sure that then makes me feel energized and makes me feel good moving forwards towards the next day. Because I had found that my energy levels were slumping a little bit, and it wasn't because I wasn't eating enough, it was because I wasn't drinking enough for the amount that I was sweating. So just make sure that you are rehydrating, feeling good, drinking lots of water, having like a hydration tablet if you have them. They're super useful. We have like a Sis one. I'll go get them. So we use these Sis hydration tabs, as well as like during training, I have this cheapo knockoff version of Powerades, but they're basically like 60 cents from Carrefour. So cheap, but they have all of the right stuff in it and it'll help you rehydrate. So yeah, these two, key to hydration, key to performance. You're welcome. Number five is one that I begrudgingly don't want to say, but it has been keeping me injury free and pain free, and that is stretching. But since doing CrossFit, it's so, so important to take the time to stretch after training, because you do so much work, your body needs to be like relaxed and like put through the motions to kind of move through that range of motion and make sure that you don't get like limited or like your muscles aren't like really, really tight. So where we hadn't done so much like upper body work before, Ross and I both started getting quite bad shoulder pain, where like our chest was getting so tight and our lats were getting so tight from all the work, and my triceps so tight because of like ski erg and stuff like that. So Ross uses GoWad, but I don't think that's 100% necessary. You can have like your own protocols or even YouTuber protocol, but basically take time after training to kind of see like specific stretches for areas that you've just trained. So day before yesterday we did like a thrusters workout, which was really, really hard, and my legs and hips and shoulders were all on fire. So I made sure to do a stretch like session specifically for that after training, like directly after training, as well as later that evening and the next morning, just to make sure that my body's still moving through the right ranges of motion. So those are my five top tips for regaining strength, regaining muscle, and kind of like having like a bit of an overhaul of your physique. Now, I don't want to say to like make my physique better or make myself look leaner or things like that, because it's really not about those goals. I think when I started focusing on gaining strength, being strong and fueling my body, the leanness or like six pack or whatever you want to call it came naturally, because I was just doing things that fueled me and made me feel better. That's what I would focus on, those five things. Hope it helps. Here my 1.5 liters post-training liquids. I just wanna say that was the best training I have had in forever. Like I said in the training, that is, like I've not felt myself until that session, and I'm so, so happy. The power snatches were unreal. I feel strong, I feel good, and I'm really, really excited. This is gonna be the year. If you guys are excited about this CrossFit journey with me and can't wait to join me on it, please do subscribe to this channel as well, to give this video a big thumbs up, because it does really support me. I'm so excited. There's so many exciting things, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Can we just talk about my muscle ups though? I mean, 6 in a row. That's insane. I just want to say I will be making a video about how I got those 6 muscle ups because it has been a long journey and none of the videos that I watched on YouTube were helpful. So I'm going to make my own video for you guys to help you. Drink your water. Hydration is key.